field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. One quarter down. Can't wait to see what the second quarter has in store. We're back to Lambeau in just a moment.
29-10, Packers lead. Packers, Panthers.
Brandon Gordon. We've had the kickoff to begin the first quarter. Now it's time for the second quarter kickoff as they take over here, first and 10. They'll start the drive with a run by Stewart. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line.
Stewart. Jonathan Stewart.
Often identifying how to block a 3-4 defense. Well, when they're coming out of blitz, even more difficult. They're elusive targets and hard to hit.
Another pistol look here. Now a 10th carry for Jonathan Stewart. And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable 3rd and 7.
On a 2nd and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance
situation. That's caught at the 25. And touchdown! Devin Funchess with his second touchdown.
Devin Funchess.
And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him, let him do the rest.
29-17.
To his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. Touchdowns on back-to-back drives. So a very good flow right now offensively.
Hard to slow them down because they are locked in. Feel like the offense coordinator is a little bit ahead of the defensive guys right now. They're beating them to the punch with their play calls. They've got a nice rhythm they're locked into. How can the defensive guys come up with something that'll disrupt that flow? That's what they're seeking right now.
It's been an exciting sequence to watch.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're the player in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. Big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
He's going to go up top again.
Bam.
And that one got tipped.
14 minutes.
Off. It brings up third.
I know the initial focus was on how far that pass was down. How about the coverage on the play? Able to stay with him. As one of the receiver's hands were going to try and catch the ball, tips it up in the air and knocks it away.
Fourth down. Dang it.
I know in most cases people think you throw the ball in this situation, and when they ran it almost felt like a little bit of a surrender, maybe a give up. But I don't know if that's really the case. They might have been probing a little bit, checking the defense and filing it away for later. They might have something working later on.
And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. And not his best effort there, as this one's going to be spotted down just outside of the 40-yard line. Here's the Packer defense getting set to go again. See if they can regroup a little bit. They gave up the touchdown last drive.
And you know from our meetings with coaches all across the league, one of their pet peeves, the teams get down. A lot of these guys now, they want to treat it like it's a video game or something. Hit reset. Let's start over, coach. Out of the first two series, they don't even matter now. Let's play again. That's not how it works. You're down. You gave up a touchdown. You can't do it again. You have to dig in, grit it out, and fight.
13 minutes.
That is driving everybody crazy. There are no reset buttons when you're playing in this game.
Preach, Chucky. Preach. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that's going to make it 3rd down and less less than a yard. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height. Sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the
first down from Panthers.
Runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They come up in an offset eye. Penalty marker is down here. They go back to Stewart on first. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage.
Out there now, 5 yards
to go on first down.
12 minutes left. Second down.
Keep it real to you guys.